I'm very grateful for your support and your patience over the past few months, and sincerely hope that you enjoy my senior recital. You can find the program notes accompanying this recital in the description of this video. What you just heard was Vedrò d'ombre infelici e pria che spunti un disi fiero from Handel's cantata E partirai mia vita. Next, Mare Chiare by Paolo Tosti utilizes a text in Neapolitan to tell a story. Typically, a song in this style would be performed as a bar song and would have been a popular tune to encourage the audience to join in as well. Please enjoy.
Share.
Rossini's La Danza is indicative of the traditional tarantella style of dance, utilizing rapidly moving notes and lively accompaniment to imitate the style of this dance, whose rhythmic pulse was said to mitigate the effects of a poisonous tarantula bite. Here's La Danza. Traveling across Europe, we now bring you to Germany in the 1700s. Johann Sebastian Bach composed his St. Matthew Passion in 1727. The text of this aria from the Passion speaks of the broken hearts of all who witnessed to the moment that Jesus was betrayed.
Thank you.
These next three selections bring us into the late classical period and early to mid-romantic era. First, two compositions by Franz Schubert explore the depths of love, one from the standpoint of someone who is brokenhearted, and the other from someone who is experiencing love like never before. The third song is a composition by Mahler and is very atypical of his style. Here you can listen for calls of jubilation as a dance takes place, and two young people, Hansel and Gretel, find joy in each other's company. this point, we will take a brief intermission. Thank you.
Thank you. Oh,
published in 1920, Le Bestiaire is Francis Poulenc's first vocal composition. The entire poem describes a variety of animals over the course of 30 poems, and originally, Poulenc set all of them. On the advice of another French composer, though, Poulenc trimmed the complete cycle to 6 songs, 3 depicting animals of the land, the camel, a Tibetan goat, and a grasshopper, and 3 depicting those of the sea, a dolphin, a crab, and the carp. Each contains elements of jokes and irony within the personification of the animal.
Thank you.
These next two compositions were both composed by Jake Heggie. The first, Snake, is part of a larger work called Evesong. Snake is the fifth movement of this collection, and the shifts in dynamic, key, and tonal center within this movement are indicative of the snake's winding and the superstitious treachery that is often associated with the reptile. The second, The Haughty Snail King, or What Uncle William Told the Children, combines the naturally syncopated, jazzy lines of the set poem with walking bass lines and unconventional modern chords to give the impression of both grandeur and bravado on behalf of the Snail King. This particular song challenges the singer to act both as narrator and snail, encouraging them to over-exaggerate the snail's sung text. Snake, is it true about the fruit? My intuition tells me what you say about this fruit is true. I'd like to find out, Snake. I'd love to know. Go ahead in front of me where I can see you. I will follow you. Ooh. The Seal Man by Rebecca Clark includes a text from a larger work titled A Mainsail Haul. Specific excerpts illustrate the treachery of a wraith who possessed a seal in order to lure a young woman into the sea, perhaps as retribution for the mistreatment he received in life. However, as punishment for the wraith's deceit, a curse was placed upon seals, neither allowing them to live entirely on land nor at sea.
Thank you.
Andrew Lehrer is a retired American musician, singer-songwriter, satirist, and mathematician. He is best known for the pithy and humorous songs that he recorded in the 1950s and 60s. Lehrer's early work typically deals with non-typical subject matter and is noted for its black humor in songs such as this one.
I do.